Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Newly released pictures show what the lavish interior of the world's largest aircraft could look like with its private ensuite bedrooms and horizon-to-horizon views during flight. Hybrid air vehicles, HAV, and design crew unveiled the Airlander 10-passenger cabin yesterday to showcase what is possible in luxury expeditionary tourism during their Rethink the Skies campaign. The £25 million aircraft, which was built in 2012 and is nicknamed the Flying Bum due to its shape, was used by the United States Army until 2016. It now belongs to Bedfordshire-based company HAV and has been redesigned for domestic use. The 150-feet-long cabin is designed to accommodate up to 18 passengers and crew members for a three-day expedition. HAV say the design is practical, feasible, and ready to go into production. It can be customized to individual customer requests. These newly released pictures show what the interior of the world's largest aircraft, the Airlander 10, could look like. The aircraft will feature horizon-to-horizon views during flight. Hybrid Air Vehicles Limited, HAV, and Design Q, who designed the aircraft, released these pictures yesterday. The Airlander 10 will have private ensuite bedrooms, pictured, and can accommodate up to 18 passengers and crew members for a three-day expedition. A spokesperson for HAV said, the altitude bar, pictured, will offer drinks with the ultimate view, while 18 guests can enjoy fine dining in the skies. According to HAV's website, the hull's aerodynamic shape, pictured, will provide up to 40% of its lift history of Zeppelins. The Zeppelin, named after Count Ferdinand von Zeppelin, is a type of rigid airship that was first designed in 1874. The exterior of Zeppelins were originally made with gold bear's skin, which is made from the intestine of cows. Zeppelins were first flown commercially in 1910, and were used by the German military during World War I during bombing raids. The luxurious aircrafts were known as hotels in the sky, and proved very popular, with airline Deutsche Luftschifffahrt (DLAG) carrying 10,000 passengers on them in just 4 years. The spire of the Empire State Building was designed to allow Zeppelins to dock above the 102nd floor, but high winds in the area meant these plans were abandoned. After the Hindenburg disaster in 1937, other Zeppelins were returned to hangars and destroyed or turned into museums. The aircraft, which is longer than most single-aisle aircraft such as the A320, can take off and land on any flat surface without a runway. HAV hope that this will mean passengers can travel in style to places existing transport cannot reach. The aircraft is 302 feet by 143 feet by 85 feet, and has one pilot station and one observer seat. HAV believes it could be used for a variety of functions in addition to leisure trips, such as surveillance, communications, delivering aid and search and rescue missions. So far the Airlander 10 has had 6 successful test flights, but in August 2016 it crashed into the grass nose first shortly after takeoff during its second flight at Cardington Airfield. The cockpit was severely damaged in the crash. The aircraft then collapsed in November last year after coming loose from its moorings. The level of luxury inside the Airlander 10 will be reminiscent of Zeppelins, which were known as hotels in the sky. Zeppelins boasted huge dining rooms and 25 private cabins, as well as cocktail bars, a lounge, and even a smoking room. Although fittings in Zeppelins were as light as possible, the walls featured murals showing routes taken by famous explorers and other Zeppelins. Airlander challenges people to rethink the skies, and that is the driving force behind everything we do, said Stephen McGlennon, the CEO of HAV. Air travel has become very much about getting from A to B as quickly as possible. What we're offering is a way of making the journey a joy. Airlander 10, which is made from Vectron, has no internal structure and maintains its shape through pressure stabilization of the helium inside the hull. A spokesperson for HAV said, Airlander 10's remarkable passenger cabin opens up new possibilities by approaching air travel from a different perspective. The jet is made from Vectron and has no internal structure, meaning the interior can easily be redesigned. It maintains its shape through pressure stabilization of the helium inside the hull. Stephen McGlennon, the CEO of HAV, said, air travel has become very much about getting from A to B as quickly as possible. What we're offering is a way of making the journey a joy. The aircraft, which is longer than most single-aisle aircraft such as the A320, can take off and land on any flat surface without a runway. The aircraft can stay in the air up to 5 days, and has a cabin which is 150 feet long, longer than most single-aisle aircraft such as the A320HAV and Design Q will continue to work together on the project, with further announcements expected later this year. Passengers on Airlander will have luxurious private en-suite bedrooms and will be able to enjoy horizon-to-horizon views in the aircraft's extensive infinity lounge. The altitude bar will offer drinks with the ultimate view, while 18 guests can enjoy fine dining in the skies. The unusually large cabin, and the lack of internal structure, means that the aircraft interior is incredibly flexible and can include reception areas, onboard catering, and various seating options. Design Q's CEO Howard Guy said, "My team exploited the opportunity that Airlander 10 presents. We had a huge space to create an experience that makes no compromises. This is luxury like you've never known it, with the ability to go anywhere in the world." HAV and Design Q will continue to work together on the project, with further announcements expected later this year. Design Q's CEO Howard Guy added, "We love doing different things. Our fantastic team of young designers relish the opportunity to do something no one's done before, to imagine a new concept and then to get into the detailed design of what this space will be."